Are you all right, Guluja?
Lots of people are dead because of my father, aren't they?
That's...
And Otis. He's gone too, isn't he?
I'm sorry.
My father is a bad man. That's why you're going to kill him, aren't you? Forget it. I don't care anymore.
Listen to me, Guluja. You're right. We're going to confront your father. He invaded Tulijolal and hurt my people. As vow of resolve, it's my duty to bring him to justice.
Don't you think of him as family anymore?
After the attack, I was filled with rage. I told myself over and over that he's no brother of mine. But it isn't so simple. No matter what I feel or say, all those years I spent striving to live up to his example, they won't just disappear. What's more, it's because we're family that we have to correct each other when someone goes astray. That's why I must confront my brother, like your grandfather did, even though it cost him his life.
But Otis is gone now. If my father was gone too, then I'd have no one.
What are you saying, Guluja? Take a look around.
You have us, Guluja. All of us. We'll be with you. Through thick and thin. You're not alone. You'll never be alone again.
Allow me. Hold on. Allow me. Thank you. Hold on. Hold on.
just the beginning.
It's not opening.
Shale, can you see to the lock?
Just a moment.
Ever reliable.
Right. Let's keep moving.
The 11th level, just below the summit.
Look, Soul South. This is where they're kept.
What?
Indeed. Many died in the attack. Their souls would have been processed and transported here for storage. Or so I had expected.
A soul cell is supposed to light up green when loaded, isn't it? Yet the light is out on most of these.
He's already used them up. That's why he cut down one of his own. For the Regulator!
Yshtola, a Destinian, too!
Lest you wonder, all is well in Tyral. The enemy has withdrawn, freeing us up to come and lend you a hand.
The backroom crew gave us a briefing. No rest for the righteous as usual, eh?
The idea of empowering oneself with souls is rather reminiscent of Voidscent practices. I should be keen to learn more about the process, after more pressing matters have been resolved.
I believe I speak for everyone when I say I'm glad you're here. As you'll have heard, the Alexandrians have suffered heavy casualties. We must stop Zeralja before it gets any worse.
Thank you for coming with me this far, my friends. And I ask you to lend me your strength one last time. Together, let us defeat Zeralja and safeguard the future of Tulihyolal.
And here is where I must excuse myself. Come back in one piece. You hear me?
We will. Every one of us. What in the world is that?
It couldn't be. A void gate.
It's enormous.
Aye. It dwarfs even the ones Aromas opened.
That is no void gate. It doesn't lead to the 13th.
Then...
Yes. In all likelihood, it's a portal to yet another reflection.
By the 12! To think that realities being fused together was only the beginning.
The speculation must wait. He's here.
Thank you.
There is a limit to how much ether a living being can harbor while retaining its physical form. Zeralja has far exceeded that limit. With the souls he has absorbed, he has attained power to rival even a king among Void Sent, but at a terrible cost.
12 have mercy!
Brother! It ends here and now!
How it vexes when you call me brother. Brother, blood heir, resilient son. Who am I? What is my path? Why was I born?
I am Wuklamat, Vow of Resolve of Tulihyolol. And you are Zeralja, King of Resolve of Alexandria. For the last time, we fight. For duty, for blood, for everything.
Yes, we fight. Hold nothing back. This multitude of souls I shall burn to the last mote. I will kill you and prove the miracle. I will prove that I am Father's true successor. Come at me with your all. I will make you kneel. Let the victor's reign be sanctioned by the blood of the fallen. I need more power.
visions are these? Out of my way! Is this my weakness given shape?
You'll not escape this!
Down with you!
Let the victor's reign be sanctioned by the blood of the fallen. I need more power. This will hurt.
I am the worthy king! There is no miracle. This is my path. I trust only in myself.
Light my blades!
Are you all right?
No mercy!
Hold still.
Brother.
So, it is to be defeat.
Father, is that you?
Why do you weep?
Because it hurts. Because I don't understand why it had to be this way. Why don't I know you? Why didn't you want me?
How could I be a father when my own spurned me? He left me nothing. No throne. No legacy. Nothing. And so, nothing to leave you.
Why does that matter? Couldn't you have just been there?
You ask a lost man for the way. do not presume to call you mine, nor do I desire anything of you. But I leave behind that which I've gained by the sweat of my brow. It is yours to embrace or spurn. I walked the path of ruin. Unable to surpass further.
You think Papa left you nothing? You God's damned fool! You have the one thing he couldn't leave anyone else. You, Uncle Ulcha.
It's not over.
Queen's Beam?
Zorolja is gone. There's no need to fight anymore. Sveen? Why are you here?
I wanted to express my gratitude to you all. For vanquishing the King of Resolve and delivering my people. And to express my regret for what I've done to yours.
Your apologies won't bring back our dead or lessen your guilt. Still, to strike you down in revenge would trigger all-out war between our nations. More innocents would suffer. Even if we cannot be friends right now, we need to find a different path forward. A way that Tulihiolal and Alexandria can coexist.
I fear that can never be.
What do you mean?
There is no other path for us. It's too late. I cooperated with Zorolja because I needed the life force yielded by the slain to sustain the Endless. Of course, the King betrayed me, and with his army defeated, that plan can no longer be realized. But I can't I won't fail my people. Be they possessed of flesh or no, all of them are dear to me. If there is something I can do for them, as their queen, I must do it.
Hear me, Sveen. We appreciate your commitment to serving the Alexandrians and have endeavored to understand your beliefs. Be that as it may, you must know it's wrong to sacrifice our living to save your dead.
I see. It's because you do not know them that you believe they're dead. They're not. So long as they are remembered, they shall never die. You understand, don't you? No matter what anyone may say, I refuse to believe that Kafkiwa's is a hollow existence, that she can simply be allowed to fade away.
Your Majesty.
I am the bearer of the memories of Queen Sveen of Alexandria, and my desire to protect my people transcends all others. For them, I will do anything. No price is too high.
Seven hells.
What is it?
There exists a legend in Alexandria. In ages past, faced with a calamity in their world, a clan of people used a singular power to flee to ours. The key which manifests this power answers to fervent desires, desperate, all-consuming supplications that have given rise to many a miracle. That key holds the secret to interdimensional fusion, and unraveling its mysteries was the foremost mission of the scientists of preservation. Alas, they failed to fully grasp its workings, leaving us with only partial control over it. Nevertheless, if I'm to sustain the inhabitants of living memory, I have no choice but to call upon its power.
And do what with it?
For hundreds of years I tried, but it was all to no avail. My benevolence did naught to protect my realm. But I can still take up arms and fight. If bloodshed will save my subjects, then I will become history's most brutal queen.
Wait!
Theme.